We want to match the graphs to the correct equations given here. Notice the first and last functions are exponential functions. And the second and third functions are log functions. So hopefully by now we can recognize that the blue and the red functions represent exponential growth functions, and the black and green functions represent the graphs of log functions. So there are several ways to identify the correct equations for the graphs, but I think when working with log functions, it's often helpful to rewrite these log functions in exponential form. Y equals log base 3 of x means that 3 raised to the power of y must equal x. So 3 to the power of y must equal x. And y equals log base 2 of x means 2 raised to the power of y equals x. So 2 to the power of y equals x. In this form, we should recognize that this first equation, y equals 2 to the power of x, and the third equation, x equals 2 to the power of y, are inverses of one another. Notice how the x and y variables have been interchanged. And the same is true for the second equation and the fourth equation. Notice how the x and y variables have been interchanged. So knowing the exponential functions and log functions are inverses of one another, it should make it easier to identify our graphs. But let's start by comparing the two exponential functions. We have y equals 2 raised to the power of x, and y equals 3 raised to the power of x. Notice how y equals 3 raised to the power of x has a base equal to 3, and y equals 2 raised to the power of x has a base of 2. Since 3 is greater than 2, y equals 3 to the power of x represents larger exponential growth, and therefore the graph of this exponential function should be increasing faster than the graph of this function here. Looking at the red and blue functions, notice how the red function is increasing faster because it's going uphill faster. Therefore, y equals 3 raised to the power of x should be the red graph, and y equals 2 raised to the power of x should be the blue graph. Of course, if we still aren't convinced, we could find points on each function. So for example, for y equals 2 raised to the power of x, if x is equal to 1, notice that y would be equal to 2. And for y equals 3 raised to the power of x, if x is equal to 1, y would be equal to 3. Notice how the red function does contain the point 1, 3, and the blue function does contain the point 1, 2. So we have identified the exponential functions correctly. And now if we recognize that y equals log base 3 of x and y equals 3 to the power of x are inverse functions of one another, if the exponential function contains the point 1, 3, then the inverse function would have to contain the point 3, 1, which would be this point here on the black function. Notice in exponential form, if y is equal to 1, x would be 3. And since y equals 2 to the x and y equals log base 2 of x are inverses, if the exponential contains the point 1, 2, then the log function must contain the point 2, 1, which we can see here would be on the green function. And therefore, y equals log base 2 of x would be the green graph. Again, notice if y is equal to 1, x would equal 2. So as I mentioned at the beginning, there are several ways to identify these graphs correctly based upon these equations, but it is helpful to recognize when exponentials and logs are inverses of one another. I hope you found this helpful.